morning. You're welcome to church. Happy Sunday. I'm happy to see everyone today in the presence of God. Today we're going to have an awesome service, an awesome time in the presence of God. If you know you are happy, if you're happy and you know, we clap your hands. If you're happy and you know, we clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Oh yes, you are so, I'm so happy. I am happy as you are. And you're welcome to the presence of God once again. So we are going to show God how grateful and how happy we are, okay, this morning by singing to God alone, okay? All right, so sing with me. Children of God, yes, wonderful children, excellent children, immaculate children, will you shout hallelujah? Shout hallelujah to the Lord five times. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Amen, amen. Amen, amen. Are you happy? Oh yes. Are you sad? Oh no. Clap for Jesus. Children of God, excellent children, immaculate children, wonderful children, blessed children, will you shout hallelujah? Shout hallelujah to the Lord four times. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Amen, 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 amen. Are you happy? Oh yes. Are you sad? Oh no. Clap for Jesus. Children of God. Children of God, wonderful children, excellent children, happy children, beautiful children, handsome children, will you shout hallelujah? Shout hallelujah to the Lord three times. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen, 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 amen. Are you happy? Oh yes. Are you sad? Oh no. Come for Jesus. One, two, three. That was awesome. That was amazing. Okay. I'd like somebody to give us a song. Who can give us a song? Anybody? Okay. I guess I should do one more song. Let's do one more song together. Okay. Okay. Oh, remember this song? Maybe we should do Father Abraham has many sons has Father Abraham. I am one of them, and so are you. So let us praise the Lord. Right hand, left hand, right leg, left leg. Turn around, sit down. Okay, that used to be our favorite song. So right now we are going to close our eyes in prayers and pray to God and ask God to take control, to teach us His word today. So let's put our hands together like we always do, and we have to close our eyes, okay, and pray to God. Oh Lord, our Father, we thank you for bringing us back to your presence. We thank you for our mommy. We thank you for our daddies. We thank you for our aunts. We thank you for our brothers, for our sisters, for our teachers, for everybody. Father, we appreciate and honor you. We thank you for bringing us back into your presence, oh Lord. We ask, oh God, that you accept all our thanksgiving this morning. We are happy to be in your presence, oh Lord. And as we come to you, oh Lord, we pray that you will teach us your word. You will give us understanding to understand your word this morning in Jesus' mighty name. And I pray, oh Lord, that your word will bless every one of us today in Jesus' mighty name. We have prayed. Amen. Amen. Everybody clap your hands for Jesus. 1, 2, 3, 4. Can we roll it for Jesus? Okay, let's do it. Roll it, roll it, and let it go. I love Jesus. Okay, now you're going to roll it for yourself. In fact, you're going to give yourself a love clap. Can we do that? I hope you remember how we give ourselves a love clap. We haven't done that in a very long while, so let's just do it, okay? All right, let's give ourselves a love clap. You all deserve it. All right, children, we'll come back, okay? We have a video we are supposed to watch, so we're going to watch the video, and when we come back, we'll continue with the class. See you then. Bye.
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do. La-la-la-la. La-la-la-la. La-la-la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do, do 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 do, do do do, la 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 la, la 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 la, la la la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
Oh, hi, friends! You're just in time to help me find 2 picture passes that match. These don't match. They're not the same. These don't match either. But look, these do match. They are the same. Friends, let's see if we can do some more matching on a Bible adventure. Shake your hands high in the sky if you'll go with me. Woohoo! Now, friends, put on your adventure bags. I think that's Shine.
Wee! Hiya, Emily. Hiya, friends.
Hiya, Shine.
What question are you asking on your Bible adventure today?
How can your heart match God's heart?
I know some picture passes you can pack to find the answer.
Friends, you and I will be picture pass guessers together.
Here's your first clue. It's a book full of God's words.
Friends, which picture pass is it? Good guess. It is the Bible. Catch it in your adventure bag. Shine, what's next?
This one can make music.
Friends, which one is it? Good guess! It is the guitar. Catch it in your adventure bag.
Now for the last one. These 2 picture passes match each other.
Friends, which 2 are the same? Friends, you've got it! The hands match. They're the same.
You're right. Look what happens when you put them together.
Wowie zowie! They make praying hands. Let's catch them in our adventure bags. Friends, count with me. 1, 2, 3. Yep, they're all here. Now let's sip our adventure back together.
Now it's time to fly!
Whoa! Whoa! But Shine, how can my heart match God's heart?
The Bible can help us.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
Stone slings and giant things. That's from the book of 1 Samuel in the Bible.
That story is about David. Let's watch and see if his heart matched God's heart.
King Saul did not obey God. So God sent Samuel the prophet to Bethlehem. "Find a man named Jesse," God said. "One of his sons will be the new king." Samuel looked at seven of Jesse's sons. They looked handsome and strong. "Not them," God said. "I don't care about looks. I care about what's in a person's heart." Jesse sent for his youngest son, David, who is tending sheep in the fields. Samuel saw him, and God said, "He is the one." So David was anointed the new king. Sometime later, Israel fought the Philistines. A giant Philistine soldier called Goliath challenged the Israelites to send a champion to fight him. But the Israelites were all too afraid. David brought food to his brothers in the army. He heard Goliath's challenge and was not afraid. "How dare he defy God's army?" asked David. "I will fight him." Surprised, King Saul offered David his armor. "No," said David. "God help me kill wild beasts. He will help me against Goliath too." David took 5 stones and a sling.
"Am I a dog?" Goliath roared. "You send this stick of a boy to fight me."
"You have a spear," said David, "but I have the help of Israel's God." David put a stone into the sling and threw it. It struck Goliath's forehead and knocked him down. The Israelites defeated the Philistines. With God's help, David was a hero.
David did good things to show his heart matched God's heart.
Yeah, he was a helper for his family, and he believed in God's power.
And he did the big, scary job no one else wanted to do. Fight Goliath!
But how did David get his heart to match God's heart? I'll go ask Guy the Bible Guy.
Good thinking. See ya, Emily.
See ya, Shine. Come on.
Hi, Emily.
Hi, Guy. Do you know about David?
I sure do. David spent a lot of time getting to know God, so his heart could match God's heart.
I think that's the answer to our question. How can your heart match God's heart? I get to know God.
And I have a very special book to help me get to know God.
I think I have a picture pass about that. Friends, which picture pass is a book filled with God's word? Super job, friends! It's the Bible! When we read it, our hearts grow to match God's.
And a heart that matches God's heart is ready to do good things for Him.
Do you have a Bible verse about that?
Sure do. Friends, wiggle your ears if you're ready to learn a verse with me.
I'm wiggling my ears. Are you wiggling yours?
Okay, listen to what the Bible says. Titus 3:1. Be ready to do what is good.
Friends, repeat it with me.
Titus 3:1.
Titus 3:1.
Be ready.
Be ready
to do what is good.
To do what is good.
Great job, friends. Now say the whole verse with us.
Titus 3:1.
Be ready to do what is good. Friends, you've got it.
Thanks, Guy. See you later.
Bye, Emily. Bye, friends.
Come on.
Children, you're welcome back. I hope we had fun watching that amazing video. I had so much fun. I love the part where David threw his sling at Goliath and Goliath fell down. Oh. Do you know what I said after when I saw that part? I called David the Giant Slayer. Yes. Oh, David the Giant Slayer. You can imagine that very little David actually bringing down a very big giant. It was not by his strength. It was not by his power. It was by God. God strengthened him by the power of God in him, and he was able to do that. So before we continue, I would like us to learn two songs. Songs that we actually know. So we're going to sing the song. The first one says, I can do all things to Christ who strengthens me. We know the song. I've taught you before in church. So can we do it together now? I'll sing it once and then sing with me. Okay? So the song says, I can do all things, all things, all things. I can do all things to Christ who strengthens me. I can do all things, all things, all things. I can do all things to Christ who strengthens me. Can we do it together now? You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you, just like David did. So let's do it together. I can do all things, all things, all things. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I can do all things, all things, all things. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You and I, we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. And the second song says, read your Bible. You know that song very well, okay? So can we do it together? All right, let's go. Read your Bible, pray every day, pray every day, pray every day. Read your Bible, pray every day, if you want to grow, if you want to grow, if you want to grow. Read your Bible, pray every day. Pray every day, pray every day. Read your Bible, pray every day if you want to grow. So if you want to grow, you have to read your Bible every day. You have to read your Bible every day. It's only when you read your Bible that you can grow. You can grow, okay? Read your Bible every day and you can grow. Okay, and the last song says, obey your mom and dad. Not just your mom and dad, you also have to obey God. Okay, we just don't obey mommy and dad, we obey God. Because without God, we are nothing. We can't do anything without God. You know that? Yes, God is the ultimate in our life. God is number one in our life. Okay, so the last song says, O-B-E-Y, obey your mom and dad. O-B-E-Y, makes them very glad. Listen to what they say, obey your parents every day. O-B-E-Y, obey your mom and dad. The next, and we're going to change it from obeying mom and dad to obeying the word of God. Can we do that? O-B-E-Y. E-Y, obey the word of God. O-B-E-Y, makes God very glad. Listen to what he says, obey the word of God. O-B-E-Y, obey the word of God. Can we do this one again? I think I love this version more. Okay, children, let's do it again. O-B-E-Y, obey the word of God. O-B-E-Y, make God very glad. Listen to what he says, obey the word of God. O-B-E-Y, obey the word of God. Yes. How many of us are going to obey the word of God? When we read the Bible, remember when you read the Bible, it helps you to grow. And when you read the Bible, you obey the word of God. it's not just you reading the Bible, or maybe mommy read the Bible for me. You also have to obey the word of God. So today, before we continue, I'd like us to go through our memory verse for today. Our memory verse is Titus 3 verse 1. Titus 3 verse 1. And it says, be ready to do what is good. Can we do it again? Titus 3 verse 1. Titus 3 verse 1. And it says, be ready to do what is good. Be ready to do what is good. I like that scripture. It's simply telling us that we should be ready at all times to do good things every time. Because when we do good things, we are obeying the word of God. And when we read the Bible every day, we match our hearts to grow with God. The story of how David was able to defeat Goliath, wasn't because David has a very physical strength. You can see he's so tiny, very tiny. And then look at the mighty strong. Goliath, with all the strength he has, with all the power, with all his physical appearance, David, the tiny David, brought him down. So from now on, I think I'm going to be calling David the giant slayer. Yes, the giant slayer. So David pleased God. David did not go to Goliath by his own strength. He told him that, I have a God. Who are you? You are insulting God. I have served a bigger God than you. You are insulting the children of Israel. And God is not happy with you. God has put it in my hands, and I'm going to crush you. And Goliath was like, oh my. Goliath felt very insulted though. Can you imagine? He was like, what? Look at this little boy. This little boy, you're talking to me like this. I'm going to crush you. I'm going to eat you. I'm going to squeeze you. And that was what Goliath said. He was boasting. He was proud because he believed in his strength. But David did not come by his own strength. David didn't come by his own strength. He has the power of God in him. And he believed that God is with him. And if God is with him, so David believed God. He believed that he has the power of God in him. And that's why he was able to defeat Goliath. Now I have a question I want to ask you. So the question says, how can our hearts match God's heart? Let's think about it. How can our hearts match God's heart? Our hearts can match God's heart when we read our Bible. When you read your Bible, our heart goes to match God. So don't you forget that our hearts can match God's heart when we read our Bible. Because by reading our Bible, we grow every day. Remember the song our song says, read your Bible, pray every day if you want to grow. Okay? It's just like, do you know that when you don't eat, you know, children, when they don't eat, you won't be able to grow. You won't grow because you're not eating. Okay? You eat good food. When you eat good food, it balances diet. It helps the children to grow. If not, you will end up being very small, very little. You will not grow to be like mommy and daddy. But then, the same way that we eat good food so that we can grow and we can grow taller, is the same way we are supposed to read the Word of God. We are supposed to read the Bible so it can help us to grow, okay? It helps us to grow. It helps us to have confidence. It helps us, it gives us the power of God. It gives us the strength to do anything we want to do, okay? So that is our class today. And I really enjoy the story of David. David, the giant slayer. Don't forget that word, that David is a giant slayer because he trusted God, because he has the power of God in him, because his heart matches God's heart. And the same way David is a giant slayer, we are also a giant slayer because we read our Bible every day. We love God. We trust God. We believe in God. And as we do that, our hearts always grow to match God's heart. Okay, so children, that's the end of our teaching today. I hope we enjoyed the story, and I hope we learned something today. We learned that we're supposed to read our Bible every day, and by reading our Bible, our heart matches, our heart goes to match the heart of God. You cannot be able to read the Bible, but mommy and daddy can read Bible stories to you, and you can ask them questions, okay? And do you know something? When you read the Bible, it makes you wiser. Seriously, it makes you wiser. It makes you wise. It makes you a friend of God. I am a friend of God. I read my Bible every day, and I pray to God every day. God is my Father. He is my friend. God is your Father, and He is your friend. All right, children. I had an amazing time today in the presence of God. So we are going to our activity today, and we'll be needing a plain paper. We'll need A4 paper. We'll need a marker or a pencil, and we'll need crayons, okay? All right, children, see you later. Hello, children. You're welcome back to our activity. An activity for today is a heart shape. We are drawing a heart shape. Okay, so I know we can't draw it ourselves, but mommy and daddy are going to help us, or our brothers, or anybody, any big auntie or uncle around us will help us to draw it, and then we'll color it red. Do you know the reason we are drawing a heart shape? We are drawing a heart shape because we learned that we can match our hearts to God's hearts when we read our Bible every day and pray. Okay, that's the way we can match our hearts to God's hearts. I know we cannot read the Bible, so that's why our mommy and daddy will help us to read the Bible to us every day, and we will pray. And when we do that, we match our hearts to God. So we'll be needing our A4 paper and a marker or a pencil. Okay, so our heart shape, I'm going to draw mine. Okay, I show you my heart shape. Okay, so a heart shape is, let me show you this way. Your finger am I doing it very well? It goes like this, okay? anyways, so I'm going to just draw it and we'll color it. Okay, so this is it here. Yeah. The first thing we do is, see, goes that way, and the next one okay, you can make your heart shape as big as you like it. So this is a heart shape, and after mommy and daddy have drawn it for us, I would like you to color it red, make it very beautiful. Okay, God has given us a beautiful heart, and God also loves us so much. Don't forget that God loves you, and that by reading the Bible every day, by telling mommy and daddy to read the Bible stories to you, and when you listen and you do what God asks you to do, you are matching your heart to God, and God loves you very much. Okay, children, so before we go, I'd like us to sing the song that, I know we know that song, we sang it earlier. So it says, I can do all things, all things, all things. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Philippians 4:16. I can do all things, all things, all things. I can do all things to Christ who strengthens me. So you can do anything you want to do through the strength of God. Just like David. David. David is a giant slayer. Just like David slayed the giants, Goliath. You can do the same thing. Don't forget to ask mommy and daddy to read stories to you. And I'll see you next week. Bye, children. Bye.
Habib, where do you think you're going?
Stay out of my way. I'm going to play football with my friends, and there's nothing you can...
Silence! You think this is funny, eh? You can get the deadly coronavirus.
The gorilla virus?
No, the coronavirus. Do you know what will happen when you do? Do you?
Huh? What will happen?
You will bring the coronavirus home and then infect everyone. Mommy will be sick, no more jollof rice.
Huh?
Daddy will be sick, no more going out to see movies.
Oh no! Not the movies, no!
Even worse, the government will come and take mommy and daddy away.
Ah, you're just making it up.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
See for yourself.
Okay, it's real, it's real. What should we do?
The coronavirus is out there. We should stay at home for now. Always wash our hands with soap and water so we can prevent it from spreading.
Boo!
Stay home, stay safe from all of us at Ant Hill Studios.